it had a lot of balls thrown at us, right?
Yeah, this camp was not an easy camp.
In the sports world, wives and girlfriends, known as wags, usually sit back and relax as their athletic husbands compete. Unless you're Rachel Marshall Donaire. The former Taekwondo champion and model has been married to Nonito Donaire Jr. for the last 13 years. And aside from raising their two boys, she's been taking on his managerial duties.
What turned me to, you know, to really step up in, first of all, the managing part and then all the other stuff is because of the fact that, you know, boxing has been known to be a dirty business. And I think sometimes if you align yourself with the wrong teams, things can happen, whether it's through the sponsorships or the promoters or the managers, and things fall through the cracks. And it ends up affecting the family in the long run.
This past year, the knockout queen has taken it a step further, serving as his head trainer and occasional sparring partner.
For the last 13 years, he looked at me when I was sitting ringside, and he would listen to me, but I'm never in the corner. So it gave us an opportunity during the pandemic to sit down and watch tapes together, really have discussions on it, and he was starting to see what I was seeing. So, you know, he was like, okay, well, let's give this a shot and see what happens.
The hard work has paid off with a 4-round knockout victory over Nordino Bali for the WBC world title in May, and then a 4-round defense against Raymar Caballo this past weekend. She has been nominated by the World Boxing Council for Trainer of the Year. Donaire's corner has become a family affair, with his original trainer, Father Nonito Sr., also working the corner, while Rachel's dad, Jerry, heads a security team.
It's amazing just to be mentioned. I think, you know, that of course the other coaches have been around for so long and they have an amazing stable of fighters, but just to be, you know, I mean, there's always that, there's only one first, right? So I hope this pushes a lot of other women to step up into the stage, to be part of camps, to be, and if possible, to be head trainer. We do have women head trainers. It just hasn't been to a world title fight yet, and I'm sure there will be way more after this.
While their 4-round knockout victory over Raymar Caballo has helped their cause, fans can still vote for her on the WBC's website. The Filipino Flash himself is also nominated in several categories, along with fellow Bohol prospect Mark Magsayo. Steve Angeles, ABS-CBN News, Los Angeles.